This video is to demonstrate the preparation and procedure to change the dressing of a vascular access device using a surgical aseptic non-touch technique. A surgical ANTT approach may be used when changing the dressing of a vascular access device and is commonly used when changing the dressing of a PIC. There is an ANTT guideline available on the NHSGGC clinical guideline platform. The guideline is useful as it contains advice surrounding the different situations or scenarios where you might use either a standard or a surgical ANTT approach. ANTT is also incorporated into each procedural template within the NHSGGC Vascular Access Devices Care and Maintenance Guideline. This guideline is also available on the clinical guideline platform. Throughout the procedure, you will be expected to follow appropriate infection control precautions with regards to performing essential hand hygiene and wearing necessary PPE. VAD dressing changes are required every 7 days or more frequently if the dressing is loose or soiled to reduce the risk of infection. I have performed hand hygiene and put on PPE. The first thing that I need to do is decontaminate the surface area that I will be using. I'm using a detergent wipe to do this. Any surface that can be decontaminated appropriately can be utilised. I'm now going to remove my PPE and perform hand hygiene and put on new PPE. The next step is to get the equipment I need ready. I will need to prepare a critical aseptic field. I'm going to use a packet of sterile swabs for this. Open the packet of sterile swabs, discard the outer packaging, and open the inner packaging that is wrapped around the swabs using an aseptic non-touch technique. I'm being careful to try and only touch the outside of this packaging and not contaminate the inner side of the packaging, as this is a sterile environment. A dressing pack or sterile drape are other examples that might be used to create a critical aseptic field. I'm now going to open the remaining equipment that I need using an aseptic non-touch technique, carefully peeling open packaging of each item and dropping gently onto the critical aseptic field. Because I'm dressing a central device, I need a chlorhexidine gluconate impregnated dressing. This dressing is designed to secrete a small amount of chlorhexidine gluconate while it is in place over the insertion site, providing antimicrobial protection against microorganisms and thereby reducing the risk of bloodstream infection. For this device, I'll use a biopatch. During this procedure, I need two wands containing 2% chlorhexidine and 70% isopropyl alcohol. It's fundamental that I use these, as it is the most effective solution at getting rid of any extrinsic microorganisms that might lead to bloodstream infection. Open the packaging of one wand onto the critical aseptic field. As I'm dressing a PIC, I also need a securing device. This will secure the catheter in place underneath the transparent dressing and reduce the risk of the catheter migrating. I need a sterile, semi-permeable transparent dressing. These dressings are waterproof and minimise moisture buildup, both of which contribute to reducing the risk of infection. The transparent section of the dressing allows visibility of the insertion site to monitor for signs of infection. I also need a pair of appropriately sized sterile gloves. I will peel open the packet of the second wand, but instead of placing this onto the critical aseptic field, I will place it to the side. You can see that the wand packaging is now a microcritical aseptic field, maintaining asepsis of the wand until I'm ready to use it. It's important that before I begin to remove the PIC dressing, that I ensure the patient is positioned comfortably with their arm extended and palm facing upwards, as this will reduce the risk of the catheter migrating during the procedure. Using the wand that is being protected in the microcritical aseptic field, tilt the wand in a downwards direction and gently pinch the wand wings until you hear a crack. Allow the 2% chlorhexidine and 70% isopropyl alcohol solution to saturate the wand sponge. I'm now going to begin removing the PIC dressing. You can see that I'm using the wand to gently remove the transparent dressing by lifting a corner of it and then working the wand underneath it. Continue to do this while removing the semi-permeable transparent dressing. If the chlorhexidine gluconate impregnated dressing has been applied correctly, then this should lift away easily with the transparent dressing. When removing the dressing, it is important to start at the bottom and remove it gently by stretching it and drawing it away from the skin in an upwards motion as demonstrated. This will minimise the risk of the catheter migrating or becoming dislodged. I've now placed the wand back into the microcritical aseptic field, as I will need to use it again in just a moment. When removing the securing device, I need to firstly open the doors at the bottom of the device using my thumbs and gently lift the catheter off the two blue prongs on the device and tilt it to one side. It is important at this stage to observe the catheter for migration. If you suspect that migration has occurred, you should stop, secure the catheter in place and escalate appropriately immediately. I'm now going to reuse my wand to encourage removal of the securing device by lifting a corner of the device and working the wand underneath it gently. The used wand should be disposed of immediately into a sharp spin as it contains a glass vial inside. Before I begin to redress the device, I need to remove my PPE, perform hand hygiene, and put on new PPE. For this part of the procedure, I need to use sterile gloves as suitable PPE. I've opened out the sterile glove packaging using an aseptic non-touch technique, again being careful to only touch the outside of the packaging while doing this. I need to pick up the edges of the gloves and ease them onto my hands, doing one hand first and then the other. You should not touch the outer surface of the gloves with your hands when you're putting the gloves on. I can now rearrange the equipment on the critical sterile field ready for use. I'm now going to hold the pick using one of the sterile swabs. This allows me to gently support the catheter while I decontaminate the insertion site and surrounding area and reapply the securing device without contaminating my sterile gloves. I have prepared the second wand for use, as I did with the first, and then begin to clean from the insertion site outwards to avoid recontamination of an area that is already cleaned. I also need to clean the wings on either side of the catheter. I'm doing this for at least 30 seconds and then I need to allow the solution to dry naturally. This also takes about 30 seconds. Dispose of the used wand immediately into a sharp spin. I'm continuing to gently hold the catheter using the sterile swab and I'm going to carefully place the new securing device underneath the wings of the catheter. Placing the catheter wings onto the blue prongs of the device and then closing over the device doors securely. I need to remove the paper backing on the reverse side of the device to expose the adhesive and then firmly apply this to the patient's skin to secure the device in place. I'm now going to apply the chlorhexidine gluconate impregnated dressing over the insertion site. If it is a biopatch dressing that is being used, it is important that the side of the biopatch with writing on it should be facing upwards and the sponge side should be facing downwards onto the patient's skin. The slit in the biopatch should be positioned down towards the securing device and slightly offset from the direction of the catheter to ensure 360 degree coverage. This also ensures the biopatch removes easily when the dressing is next changed. Finally, I'm going to apply the semi-permeable transparent dressing on top of the securing device and biopatch dressing. Following completion of the procedure, I can dispose all used equipment into the clinical waste, remove my PPE and perform hand hygiene. Redressing of the vascular access device should be documented in the associated care plan. To summarise, this video demonstrated a surgical ANTT approach to changing the dressing of a VAD, using a pick as an example. This surgical ANTT approach may be appropriate when dressing other vascular access devices.